There are disruptive changes sweeping across the world because of the fourth industrial revolution and rapid technological advances. There are jobs that do not yet exist, and knowledge and skills that are not yet available in the curricula of many universities. We'll have to reimagine new models of learning and adjust the way we teach and learn.
This is phosphorus. This is carbon. You're going cold now.
Yes.
Professor Lo loves diamond and gold.
We build software, build solutions to actually help our customers be more efficient as well.
We aim to be a leading global university that inspires and innovates for positive societal impact.
身体觉得好吗?
As the National University, NUS intends to be at the forefront of this revolution, to nurture leaders of society working together in the spirit of innovation and enterprise. We will embed lifelong learning in the NUS DNA to ensure that we create knowledge and value for Singapore and Singaporeans.
Congratulations, class of 2023. Today marks a significant milestone in your education journey, and we are happy to celebrate your achievement with you. Despite the challenges posed by the pandemic in the past few years, I'm proud that you have pushed through and emerged victorious. I believe that our science education has prepared you well to tackle challenges in a methodical way and to adapt as circumstances change. I'm pleased that our students have embarked on meaningful projects to address current societal issues, from helping seniors with digital connectivity to developing structured sports mentoring program for at-risk youths and leveraging technology to facilitate climate projects between businesses and citizens. Our students have also shown empathy, resilience, and adaptability during the pandemic by coming together to support each other and staying connected despite physical distancing. As you move on to to your next phase of life, I hope that you will continue to make a positive impact to society and to those around you. We are currently living in a world of disruptions and transformation in industries, and we need to continue to pick up new knowledge and skills. NUS is committed to your learning journey and offers around 700 courses for you to upskill and reskill for the fast-changing workplace. I encourage you to come back and take part in these learning opportunities so that you continue to grow and excel in your professional and personal life. Even as you celebrate your success today, do take time to reflect and show your appreciation to those who have been a source of strength and support to you over the years. Your family, loved ones, friends, and teachers. Once again, on behalf of the Faculty of Science, my heartiest congratulations to the class of 2023. We warmly welcome you to the Science Alumni family.
Dear class of 2023 FOS graduates, please accept my heartiest congratulations on your graduation from NUS. You have all come a long way and successfully completed your journey with us, particularly having overcome many unforeseen challenges in the past few years of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, look to your left and to your right and say great job to your fellow graduates. And of course, give yourselves a good pat on your shoulders as you celebrate this major milestone in your lives. Despite how COVID-19 impacted our way of life and your university experience, I hope that many of you have already found and embarked on a job or path that you are happy with. You can now apply what you have learned here in NUS in the real world. For those of you who may be in temporary roles at the moment, stay positive and believe that your situation will improve in the near future. With adversity comes opportunity, so make use of this chance to learn as much as you can. As we always say, learning does not stop after your university phase. Learn about new ideas, perspectives from your co-workers. Learn about the global challenges facing the world. Learn more about yourself and chart your own path ahead. Even though you are not from the CHS cohort, you'll find that you have to embrace new inter- and multidisciplinary approaches to solve problems ahead. So be imaginative and be excited about building your own meaningful and fulfilling future. As you take on new challenges, however, I would like to remind you to take care of yourselves, especially your mental health. Self-care is very important in today's societal climate. Give yourself ample time to grow and cut yourself some slack when things might not go as smoothly. For sure, show compassion to others around you, build an inclusive and welcoming community at your workplace and with friends and family. Now look to your front and back and say, take good care to your fellow graduates. Of course, you are now a part of our Science Alumni family. Do remember to keep in touch with your favorite academic mentors and administrative staff. Send them updates as you progress in your lives. I always find it gratifying when former students email me to let me know how they are doing. And please do come back to FOS to visit. You are always welcome to join us for alumni activities and share your real-world experiences with your juniors. Basically, don't forget us. Once FOS, always FOS. I say that as a fellow alumnus from the class of 2003. Wow, that's 20 years ago already. Wear your FOS badge proud, do us proud in your future endeavors, and change the world around you. Stay positive, stay safe. Congrats again.
Congratulations to the class of 2023. You have all persevered through a very challenging time in our history, but this has not stopped any of you from moving forward. This graduation milestone is a testimony of that. I cannot wait to hear and see many more of your accomplishments in years to come. Be bold, continue to be courageous, adaptable, and inventive, as you have all been thus far. Be the best you can be. If opportunities do not knock, you build the door. If the road ahead is foggy, you shine the light and create the environment to move forward. That seemed to be the spirit that defines the class of 2023. Best wishes from all of us at the Faculty of Science, NUS.
The Faculty of Science, NUS, is building a shared tomorrow today. Tomorrow begins here, with a world-class science education in a leading global university. The faculty's undergraduate program is offered under the College of Humanities and Sciences, a bold step in interdisciplinary learning with unprecedented flexibility for students to design unique learning pathways based on their interests and aptitudes. We nurture future-ready graduates through innovative learning experiences in cutting-edge facilities. And through EuROps, they will work independently on topics they choose to experience the joys and challenges of research. Our undergraduates broaden their horizons and gain practical experience through field trips at home and abroad, on internships in the working world, and on global exchange programs. Our postgraduate programs empower individuals who believe a degree is a milestone in a lifetime of learning. Many programs are co-delivered by industry partners. Their contributions keep our curriculum relevant to market needs. The same search for a better tomorrow drives our research. We focus on fields of scientific and societal importance to advance scientific knowledge to impact lives. From driving the next quantum revolution to advancing sustainable development, we contribute to food security through new science-based urban farming solutions. Our research creates impact, contributes to addressing complex global challenges. It informs climate action priorities in Singapore. We also focus on translational outcomes with research to discover novel materials, contribute to Singapore's net zero emissions vision, and transform treatments for diseases. Through our researchers and their quest for answers, through our vibrant student community, alumni, and future-ready graduates, the faculty is building a shared tomorrow.
Are you ready for graduation?
No.
Is the working world ready for me?
Hi guys, I'm MJ from Just Keep Thinking.
And I'm Fauzi from TSL. We're here in campus to ask students what they think about their life after graduation.
In the future, I want to go into ESG and go into the finance sector.
Actually, I have nothing like fully planned out yet. I just graduated and I'm like new to this adulting and working world. So I'm just gonna go with the flow and see how it goes.
We study a lot of like electrical stuff, okay, but we are not like aircon repairmen, as what many people say. I'm going on as a network engineer. Perhaps after that, I might want to upskill myself, take on a master's.
Do you know there's a NUS lifelong learning program available?
I've seen a website before, but I'm not really sure what is that about.
You can take courses and upgrade your skills to stay relevant and competitive in the workforce.
NUS alumni get e-vouchers, which you can use to redeem one full fee module. I'm going to sign up for a course now.
Wait. Yeah, you can just sign up using your phone.
Okay,
go all the way there. Come, let's do it together.
Oh.
Skill.nus.edu.sg.
Wow.
Today is special. I've spent my whole life preparing for this. But it isn't just about me. It's for a special someone.
For me, okay?
Who has made sacrifices for my aspirations and my dreams? Today, I remember how I got here and who made it all possible.
The biopsy results have revealed that you have stage 4 breast cancer. I'm sorry.
Today is special. For the people who never gave up on me. The people who made me believe that tomorrow will always be better. Ma, I did it. Thank you.
Dear class of 2023, my congratulations to each of you. Today, we celebrate your achievements and the moments that have led you here, where you push yourselves to learn and grow, emerging stronger, wiser, and ready to take on the world. You are channeling main character energy today. But the one thing that all main characters face are character-defining moments. As you step into society, you will encounter many such moments where you find yourself between a rock and a hard place, where right and wrong isn't so clear-cut, and complexities abound. In such times, we hope you will rely not just on the skills and knowledge you have gained here, but also on the values that we hold dear. Integrity, respect, innovation, excellence, and resilience. The path ahead is yours for the picking. Wherever it may lead, NUS is committed to being your lifelong learning partner to help broaden, deepen, and diversify your skills and equip you to seize new opportunities amid fast-evolving times. We welcome you to the NUS alumni family, and hope you will stay connected to this vibrant community that continues to make waves in every field of society. Class of 2023, congratulations on a job well done and a momentous milestone achieved. I wish you all the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony is about to begin. Please turn off your mobile phones or switch them to silent mode. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
We'll be right back. I declare open this ceremony for the presentation of graduates in the Faculty of Science. Please be seated.
The speaker for this ceremony is Dr. Zhao Jingyuan, Group Chief Data Officer at Great Eastern. Dr. Zhao is a thought leader in data and artificial intelligence, AI, nurturing these capabilities and talents across the Asia-Pacific region. Before joining Great Eastern, she held leadership positions in data and AI across different industries, including the Lazada Group, where she managed regional data analytics, and NTUC Enterprise, where she led its Advanced Analytics Center. Dr. Zhao has been a guest speaker in numerous talks and conferences here and overseas. She is ardent about nurturing young talents and teaches data science and big data-related courses as an adjunct associate professor at the Faculty of Science. She was named in the Singapore 100 Women in Tech 2021 list in recognition of her contributions to the technology sector. Dr. Zhao Jingyuan will now deliver the commencement address.
Mr. Baron Sharu, NUS Trustee, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations to all the graduating students of NUS Statistics and Data Science and Environmental Studies. This is indeed a momentous occasion. I'm honored to be here to share this special day with all of you. Today, as I look at each one of you with your beaming smiles, I'm reminded behind each smile lies a unique story of the journey you embark on to become the better version of yourself. The journey was surely filled with moments of joy, frustration, excitement, and hope. Allow me to take this opportunity to share some of my experiences and three pieces of advice on how you can shape a better version of yourself. First and foremost, I want to emphasize the importance of pursuing your passion. After completing my PhD of statistics at NUS, I initially followed the common path of becoming a postdoc researcher. However, after 4 years, I found myself feeling lost. Through self-discovery, I found that my passion did not lie solely in developing new algorithms, but in implementing them to tackle real-life problems. With that realization, I made a decision to switch gears and pursue a career in industry. In my initial years, I faced a challenge. As business stakeholders will hesitate to adopt statistical modeling and machine learning, I decided to enhance my communication and clearly explain business value of my work rather than just focusing on business technology components. Everything changed when I embarked on my third project. I successfully developed a new product by using machine learning algorithm. 3 years later, I joined Lazada. At that time, Lazada is a startup that just entering its third year. Interestingly, I quickly realized I'm the only woman in technology division, facing the common challenges faced by women in male-dominated tech industry. I comforted myself and worked hard to achieve my goals. Throughout my journey in the past 10 years, my passion has led me to be a woman leader in tech. Never let job, gender, or race define your potential. Stay ready to discover yourself, pursue your passion, and have the courage to unlock your true value. The second piece of advice I want to share is the importance of embracing uncertainty. Life is a constancy of change, and it's how we respond to these changes that define us. Over the past decade, the revolution of data and AI has been phenomenal. The volume of data generated every day has skyrocketed, and AI has transformed from fiction to reality. I and countless other data and AI professionals view uncertainty as an opportunity to experiment with new ideas and foster a mindset of continuous learning. This approach leads to significant organizational growth and personal development. By now, many organizations reimagine their business model and strategy with AI and ESG, environmental, social, and governance. As professionals in these two domains, each one of you here today will encounter uncertainty at various points in your career. Remember, your attitude and your mindset can make all the difference in the face of uncertainty. Embrace it, for it will shape you into a resilient and adaptable individual. The third and final piece of advice I want to share is the importance of fostering relationships. The relationship we build along the way shape our unique journey. Over the past 5 years, my work has centered around leading organizational transformation with data and AI. Although I have expertise in technology, I initially lacked a full understanding of business operations. Through interaction with business professionals, I have gained a deeper understanding of how organizations operate and the challenge they face. This exposure has enabled me to better develop strategy and deliver business outcomes. During this journey, I recognize the significance of developing strong and trusted relationships with business professionals. Building meaningful relationships has been a two-way street. By fostering relationships and contributing back to society, you will cultivate a network of individuals who uplift and encourage each other to reach greater heights of success and well-being. As you continue on your journey, remember these pieces of advice. Pursue your passion, embrace uncertainty, and nurture meaningful relationships. By doing so, you will shape not only a better version of yourself, but also a better world around you. Once again, huge congratulations to the class of 2023. Be proud of your past achievements and look forward to new passions and new goals. Here, I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have earlier been conferred. Doctor of Philosophy. Hitoshi Iwasaki. Huang Jingyan. Rahul Rahman. Sim Seng Long Bertrand. Xie Jia Hui. Yu Xue Jun. Master of Science, Amit Sharma. Huang Yi Xiang. Laura Lim Hui Min. Master of Science Statistics, Ding Xiaoyue. Gao Ge. Gu Rui Jia. Guo Jin Yu. He Le Fei. Huang Yi Na. Joanna Keck Chuina. He Jia Hui. Lan Jingbo. Li Jingying. Li Jingying. Lee Kersin. Lee Tian Tian. Lee Wen Si. Lee Xin Wei. Lee Xin Yi. Lee Xuan Man. Lee Yi Nan. Liu Chen. Liu Jiazhou. Lu Miran. Ma Meng Xin. Meng Yuan. Miao Di. Miao Ming Yue. Niu Fang Xin. Ran Ling Qian. Sabarinath Vinod Nair. Shang Yu Qing. Shi Han Yu. Su Jia Huang. Wang Chan. Wang Fei. Wang Jinghao. Wang Xinxian. Wei Dongqian. Wu Hairong. Wu Yiqiao. Wu Zicheng. Xu Chang. Yo Mingjie, Jonathan. Ying Zi. Yu Jingxian. Yu Lu. Zhang Tong Tong. Zhang Yihang. Zhao Bingying. Zheng Chaoju. Zheng Wenxuan. Zhong Anrong. Zhou Yongqi. NUS Waseda University Double Degree Program, Bachelor of Science. Nicole Miu Takagi. Bachelor of Science. Winner of the Saw Swee Hock Gold Medal, Sumitha Loganathan. Agatha Phyllis Chandra. Colin Go Li Xuan. Geraldine Li Jingwen.
Isabella So Xiao Si. Jaslyn De Jie Qi. Jiang Wan Qi. Qi Fang Min. Li Zhonghui Julian. Mabel Lee Wei Ling. Nadira Binti Lamri. Nur Irdina Binti Iskandar. Kwek Yu Chen. Rachel Wong Shi Yuan. Song Jin Zhe. Do Wan Ni Brianna. Zhang Rui Tong. Dipasuka at Bert. Liu Kang Javier.
Mr. Presiding Officer, may I present the graduates on whom the following degrees has earlier been conferred. Bachelor of Science, Data Science and Analytics. Winner of the MAS Academic Excellence Prize and Singapore Prison Service Data Science and Analytics Prizes. Evan Ang Jia Jun. Winner of the Legion Industrial Development Medal, Tan Itai Adam. Winner of the Singapore Prison Service Data Science and Analytics Prize, Bong Jo Yi. Winner of the Maple Tree Prize, Liu Ting Yen. Adeline Wong Yu Fang. Ahmad Ashodiquel Amin BMT. Andrea Cho Li Shi. Anika Li Ting Hui. Kyle Che Jia Min. Chan Pek Hui. Chan Wen Yong. Chan Zhen Hao Benny. Chen Ziwei. Qiu Bang Yao Paul. Jin Shu Wen Kelly. Chu Chun King. Chu Yan Ru. Chun Ming Chun. Chris Yu Jia Jie. Crystal Wun Xin Yi. Christine Tanya Sukadi. Chua Min Xin Grace. Chua Xin Xuan. Chua Yong Xin. Claudia Chan. Dion Li Yi Zi. Francelyn Benita. Gary Jensen. Glenn Lee. Go Jia Jun. Go Jofin. Hans Christian. He Mingke. Heng Kim Ling. Oh Ka Sin Kareen. Jason Chao Si Yuan. Jeffrey Gui Xiang En. Jennifer Chessa. Joel Chu Yi Xian. Joey Tan Xing Yi. Jonathan Wee Tsun Wei. Jordan Rahul Sabana Yagam. Kathy Frisilia Jaya. K. Eng Tong. Keith Tae Siang Ray. Ku Yu Ling. Recipient of the Student Life Award, Kim Soo Bin. Ko Kai It. Ko Shi En. Koi Ziming. Kok Jen Yi. Kok Jin Wei. Christy Lee. Crystal Tae Ka Sin. Kui Yu Fei. Lao Ming Xuan. Li Jin Han. Li Jun Xian Daryl. Li Min Li. Li Wei Qing. Li Zi Xuan. Liu Feng Yifei. Lee Ke-yo. Li Zi-qing Esmond. Lim Jedidiah. Lim Jingxiang. Lim Si Chen Terry. Lim Yuan Zhen. Lim Zihong. Recipient of the Student Life Award, Lo K. Chi. Lo Hong Zhen. Lo Jia Lin. Lo Min Yu. Lua Zunan. Lü Xiaoyue. Madeline Lim Chia Bin. Muhammad Soalahin bin Muhammad Fadurrahman Bekitil Gil. Nitan Ang Jia Jun. Ng Mai Feng. Yuan Dang Hai Wen. Wen Min Hu. Nigel Isaac Chua Kiet Fang. Nivedita Narela. Nuru Suhaina. Ou Jianhui. Ong Cheng Xiong. Recipient of the Tham Ng Kiam Arts Award, Pan Yuting. Park Che Xiong. Pei Zi Wei. Hua Wenxi.
Mr. Presiding Officer, I present the graduates on whom the following degrees have earlier been conferred. Bachelor of Science, Data Science and Analytics. Quek Su Ning. Rainer Tang Zheng Yang. Ryan Lee Ting Chun. Samuel Cristianto Jong. Sanraj Mitra. So Lin Min. Shreya Shriram. Xia Jen Hao. So Chen Jie. Sophie Dharmawan. Sun Hao Ting. Tan Hui Hu, Andrea Christabel. Tan Jie Yi. Tan Wei Da Jeremy. Tan Yi Jet. Tan Ying Xian. Tao Xin Ran. Tay Ying Jie Isaac. NOC program. Teo Yoke Sheng Clifton. Ter Shi Yun. Tessa Leo Li Yi. Chu Shu Rui. Tang Jing Jie. Timothy Wong Hui Fien. To Yu Sheng. Torin G. Panicker. Jun Yok Nia Tai. Tu Zhihao. NOC program, Varden To Eng Chung. Wan Yang Yi. Wong Si Yong. Recipient of the Student Life Award, Wong Yok Ling Noel. Wong Jie Teng. Yu Cheng Hong. Yu Shangzi. Yu Wei Ye. Xia Ya Xin. Xiao Tan Le. Xu Xing Lu. Yang Jing Yi. Yang Zhou Lin. Yang Zhechang. Yi Zhong Yi Zoe. Yip Jia Tong. Yu An Chi. Zhang Simian. Zheng Jingwen. Zhou Yu Nong. Zhu Enyao. Lim Cheng Shuan. Bachelor of Environmental Studies, Lam Jia Jun. Winner of the NUSS Medal for Outstanding Achievement, Ho Song Tai. Winner of the To Chin Chai Prize, Dennis Tan Wei Jie. Winner of the RCSC BES Prize, Yu Ke Yao. Recipient of the Student Life Awards and USP Scholar, NUS College, Ao Jun Ning Claire. USP Scholar, NUS College, Tasha Pua Xin Xi. Audrey Lim Ya Tzu. Chai Min Yu. Deborah Go Chen Ling. Li Wei Chiang. Lim Hui Mei Victoria. O Shi Ling. Shanis Ng Wei Jing. Cheryl Chan Su Ung Un. So Brian. Tan Hui Min Steffi. Tan Shi Yang. Tio Shui Shen. Tu Fan Ning. USP Scholar, NUS College, To Jie Ying. Chua Kai E. Kelly. Dominicus Bimaputra Sigiono. Yeah. recipient of the Student Life Award, Fu Fang Jun, Elliot Owen. Lau Wei Song Willis. Leticia To Yin Yi. Eng Zhu Yang Edwin. Nim Hui Yi. Rachel Tan Sinye. Ryan Lim N. Min. Saw Se Zhe. Wen Pei Yuan. There are two valedictorians for this ceremony. The first valedictorian is Mr. Dennis Tan Wei Jie, who graduates with a Bachelor of Environmental Studies with honors, highest distinction, and a minor in Geographical Information Systems. He was placed on the Dean's List for three semesters, received the To Chin Chai Prize and the Ning Ang Kongsi Residential College Scholarship for Academic Excellence. An alumnus of Tembusa College, who was presented with the Kathy Ong Prize for contributions to biodiversity conservation in the region. He also presented his honors thesis and his undergraduate research opportunities program in environmental studies, Europe's research on blue carbon and urban natural climate solutions, respectively, at international conferences. Dennis is currently working as a geospatial analyst at a technology company, where he uses remote sensing and artificial intelligence for sustainable agriculture and nature-based solutions. Mr. Dennis Tan Wei Jie will now deliver his speech.
Mr. Baran Shari, NUS trustee, Dr. Zhao Jingyuan, Group Chief Data Officer, Great Eastern Adjunct Associate Professor, Faculty of Science. Distinguished guests, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon. It is truly an honor and privilege to be representing the class of 2023 here today. To all the people who supported us along this journey, thank you. We want to specifically thank the following groups. To our families, for your unwavering love, your patience, and for being a constant. To our professors and lecturers, thank you for training us to be the interdisciplinary leaders that we are today, and for turning up to class, even when we sometimes didn't. To our fellow friends, thank you for all the conversations that we've had over breakfast and lunch, for meeting up to study, but spend more time taking breaks or going to get snacks, and for growing together from fresh-eyed first years into the graduates that we are today. To all the people who made our university journey a little better, to the administrators behind ENV Help, to Yi Ching, to Frontier's drink store uncle, the Dex jet food auntie. Thank you. For many of us, coming into university was a moment of finding others who shared a common passion. Never had I seen so many reusable straws or metal cups in one place. But never had I also had so many thought-provoking conversations about the environment, nor seen so many people willing to give of themselves to protect the earth we call home. Things are very different since that first semester that we stepped into university here. We've seen how university life has changed with the pandemic, and we have also witnessed how it has since settled, not into what we remember, but into a new way of life. I still remember vividly the moment that the circuit breaker was announced. I was with my GET 1050 group mates, and we were lying around the residential college lounge, silent, somber, and in a strange state of grief. Our hopes of continuing our lives as normal had evaporated. I'm sure all of us here have felt that same feeling of hopelessness at moments beyond our control. Perhaps it was when we read about the wildfires raging in Australia, or when we failed an exam for a module that we couldn't SU. Or maybe it was when we saw the closure of YH's LiHo or Fine Foods Gong Cha. Yet, hope is always there. LiHo and Gong Cha came back. We managed to graduate. Nature is recovering down under. And as the world recovered from the pandemic, many of us did too. Some of us grew closer to peers through meeting and gathering to watch lectures together in groups of five, or, you know. And some of us found new hobbies, be it spin or photography. And some of us are now working or going to work in industries that we never imagined ourselves in, because an internship we settled for turned out to be a dream job. So as we walk into the future, as we advance in our lives, let us hold on to that hope. The hope that we can make the world a better place. The hope that no matter what comes our way, we will overcome it as we have before. The hope that we will always have a community who shares our aspirations. Because with hope comes courage, optimism, and the determination to face the challenges of our day with the same fervor that we did as students. The challenges of our generation may seem intractable, but remember that even the great hills and giant trees bow to the winds. And as we walk forth from today, may the world say that the winds of change graduated today. Thank you.
The second valedictorian is Dr. Rahul Rahaman, who graduates with a Doctor of Philosophy in Statistics. His research addressed the challenges of machine learning-based computer vision under data scarcity. Over the course of his PhD candidature, he authored publications in top-tier machine learning conferences and journals. The majority of his publications challenge the traditional approaches of machine learning in a low data setting and propose solutions to create better calibrated models. This is critical in intelligent healthcare systems and human activity monitoring systems. Dr. Rahman is currently working as an applied scientist at Amazon. He applies his research solutions and machine learning expertise to safeguard consumers around the world from malicious advertisements. Dr. Rahul Rahman will now deliver his speech.
Thank you so much for the introduction. A very good afternoon, Mr. Bharin Shari, NUS trustee, Dr. Chao Ching-Wan, Group Chief Data Officer, Great Eastern, Adjunct Associate Professor, Faculty of Science, distinguished guests, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen. I am extremely humbled and honored to be one of the valedictorians for this graduating cohort out of Faculty of Science. I congratulate all the graduates who are present today here. It's an ending of a defining chapter for all of our lives. Some of us today are receiving this degree, which will be the stepping stone for higher education. For some of us, this degree is the last degree that we will ever obtain from the world of formal education. But what's common among all of us is that this is the day we receive the recognition for our work and effort that we have put up for the past few years. We have all earned this degree, this day, this celebration. I look at this auditorium full of graduate students and I see so much promise. There is no end to what we can do and will achieve in our near future. The failures, the successes, the connections we have made, the skills we have picked up, it's all going to be useful in our future. There is a famous quote from Albert Einstein that you might have also seen in one of the NUS shuttle buses as well. It says, "Education is what remains after one has forgotten what one has learned in school." We might forget some of the lessons that we have learned here, but what will really stick with us is the art of learning that we have mastered while studying here, the soft skills that we have picked up. No amount of time will put a rust on all of those things. It is surprising how much of the things that we sometimes never even consider as learning actually end up being useful in our lives. Take the example of the journey of a typical PhD student. We perform experiments spanning over months, over years, meticulously gathering data with scientific accuracy, collating every detail into a research paper that we send to the scientific community for approval. Sometimes we are lucky and it gets approved on the first go. Sometimes it doesn't. It goes through revisions after revision, rejection after rejections. We still carry on until the paper finally reaches in its final form of a publishable and acknowledged research paper. The thrill and joy of getting a paper accepted and its impact may diminish over the time, but what will really stay with us is the discipline that we have made to work on the same problem day after day tirelessly. The defense that we put up against self-doubts in challenging times, such as rejection of a paper, something worse. These things will always stay with us. So let us relish, treasure, and take with us everything that we have experienced throughout our NUS journey. There are so many memories attached to my NUS days, the endless last-minute submissions of assignments, and then afterwards taking a stroll towards nearest 7-Eleven to grab something to eat, the nights of sleepless, intense draft editing before we submit our paper to conferences and journals. There are a few things that I will definitely miss that is particular to our Faculty of Science. The free-flowing ideas and knowledge that we gained from the seminar and the classes, the intellectually stimulating discussions with our peers and seniors, the endless banter we had over a plate of hot food at Science Canteen. I'm sure all of us, the days spent at NUS will be very memorable, especially for the graduates who are leaving behind the world of academia and moving towards something outside, industry, business, anything. On an ending note, on behalf of my cohort, I would really like to thank all the people who made this day possible, the ever-helpful professors with their wisdom and guidance, the university staff that who kept helping us with a great smile on the face, the friends and colleagues who we shared this journey with, and of course the family members who never stopped encouraging us throughout the whole journey. I would like to thank my family for supporting my decision to quit my job and go abroad and enroll into a PhD program, especially my wife who stood by me during the entire PhD tenure through all the ups and downs, through all the happy and not so happy days. Once again, my heartiest congratulations to all the graduates. May we all work with great passion towards whatever direction we choose to work on. May we all achieve great things in the field of science. Thank you.
Dear graduates, as we come to the end of today's ceremony, we would like to extend our heartiest congratulations to you on your commencement. We warmly welcome you to the NUS alumni family.
I declare this ceremony closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem.
As we remain standing, my fellow graduates, this is a proud day for all of us and for our parents and loved ones who have supported us in our journey here. Therefore, before we leave this auditorium, let us take this opportunity to show our appreciation for our family and friends with a round of applause. Please join me in this gesture.
Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.